Good morning, everyone. It's Lambert Rock Strikes Back once again. And the time is now 6:35 a.m. in the UK. So, hope you're having a good day so far. I just woke up and I got time to do one review before I go to work. So, today I'm going to review on Chicken Run. Chicken Run came out the year of 2000, the same year as Tiffany Goes to School, Little Mermaid, to X-Men, Road to El Dorado, Dora the Explorer, Clifford the Big Red Dog, etc. I'm not going to explain the plot, I'm just going to leave it as it is. So guys, I haven't seen this film in a very, very long time. I haven't seen this movie in so many years. That's right, I haven't seen this movie in so many years. As you guys don't know, this is Aardman's very first movie. I repeat, the very first Aardman movie. This is the one that started all. Yep, from the same company who made Wallace and Gromit, this is their very first movie. So, if you guys want to know my thoughts on the film, I'm going to tell you a little backstory. When I first discovered this movie, I first watched this movie when I was a very young kid. That's right, I first watched this film very young kid. This is way before I became a YouTuber. This is way before I came to YouTube. This is way before YouTube was invented. This is way before I came to YouTube. This is way before I started my YouTube career. I first watched this movie at my school. That's right, I first watched this movie at my school. And I do remember the day we had a movie day, and then the teacher would say we're gonna watch a film, and then we'd watch Chicken Run. And I was like, okay, cool, a movie. So I watched most of the film during class, and then we had a lunch break, and then later we went back, we finished the film, and I had a great time watching it. And BBC One does air this film quite a lot during the Christmas season. During the Christmas season, they do air Chicken Run constantly, quite a lot of times, because, I mean, you guys know Aardman is a British company, and of course, you guys know I'm a British YouTuber. So, I gotta say, I haven't seen this movie for so many years. I don't know the last time I watched this film. I think it's like 2014 on Sky, on BBC One, something like that. That's the sometime I last time I watched this movie. As you probably know, this is the film I never got around to review on my channel, and of course, this is the this is the movie I never got released on my channel. I did What Do You Think of This Movie on a video I did exactly 5 years ago. I was browsing for Netflix to look for a movie that I consider watching, and I did review on Wallace and Gromit. So me and my YouTube friend Jeremy were planning what should I review on my channel to keep my channel going. And then he suggested me to review on Chicken Run. I was like, okay, you know what? Let's review on Chicken Run because I want to keep my channel going. So I rewatched Chicken Run lately on Netflix. And so what I think on this movie on rewatch? What can I say, guys? It's a classic. That's right. Chicken Run. It's a classic. It's a masterpiece. This is the one that started all Aardman. This is because Aardman never fail us. They've made great films. Now, I've never seen Early Man. That's right, guys. I've never seen Early Man, which that's probably the only Aardman movie, and Shaun the Sheep 2 are the only two Aardman films I have not watched. I did watch the sequel last night, by the way, guys, Chicken Run 2, which I will get to that review. I will get to that review after I finish work. Those are two Aardman films I never watched, but I will consider watching them during my channel. So I gotta say, I had a pleasant time rewatching this film after so many years. Now, I was gonna buy a DVD for it and do an opening logo to it, but unfortunately HTV didn't have any copies. And I was like, you know what, I'll just go on Netflix and just watch and rewatch the film. So yeah. But if I ever see a DVD of it, I might consider buying it. So we'll see how the future holds, guys. So yeah. So anyway, guys, let's get into the story. The story about the chickens had to escape from the farm from the evil villain, Miss Tweedy. That's her over there. Was a very great premise. This is such a great premise. It has a really great premise, and the animation for a 2000 film, I was really impressed. Very impressed for a 2000 movie. This is the animation of this movie is brilliant. It still holds up to this day. And the humor is absolutely great. There's some few good scenes in this movie I really enjoyed. Let's get into I have two favorite scenes of this movie. My favorite scene is the pie machine scene when they're trying to escape from the pie machine, which I gotta say, that is actually the best scene of the entire movie. And also the climax. The climax of this movie is spot on. It is a great climax and a great way to start Aardman's studio. And of course, we have Miss... And of course, we had the villain herself, Miss Tweedy. Basically, as you probably know, she hates chickens, just like Mog from Loud House, where she hates the Louds. Basically, her goal, she wants to kill the chickens and turn it into chicken pie. That's right, that's her goal. Sorry guys, just coughed back. I was saying, guys, yeah, that's her. I gotta say, oh boy, she is bad news. And then we have her ex-husband, which is they go to the divorce. He's a decent character, I gotta say. And the two rats over there, Nick and Fletcher, they're great characters. I really like Nick and Fletcher. They are such a great and entertaining characters at the same time. I absolutely thought the climax was so epic, and it's such an engaging climax, and I was engaged from beginning to end. And I mean, for a 2000 movie, I'm still very impressed how great this film still holds up the test of the time. But I gotta say this, guys, so yeah, with great animation, great characters, great humor, And of course, I cannot forget. And last year we have the long-awaited sequel, Chicken Run: Dawn of the Nugget. That is the long-awaited sequel to Chicken Run. Kind of like we waited such a long time to get an Incredibles 2, which we know how long we waited for that film. And yes, even Avatar: Way of Water. And also this movie came out in December 15th, which and. Yeah, it didn't really affect me because it's actually on Netflix, this film is actually released on Netflix. My reaction is it was released on Netflix. I was actually okay with it because and yes, guys, I did watch Chicken Run: Dawn of the Nugget last night on my phone on Netflix while I was talking to my YouTube friend Jeremy and who's a critic and yeah, this is a good sequel. However, it's not as good as the first film, but I still enjoy the movie, but I know I'm nearly a year late on this film, so yeah. And of course, it also has a video game from the Game Boy, Dreamcast, the same who made two classic games like Sonic Adventure and Sonic Adventure 2 Battle, and Game Boy Color, and of course the PlayStation 1, which that console is best known as they released the great classic Crash Bandicoot and Spyro the Dragon, which those two games I mentioned are absolute classics. Chicken Run is the introduction. This film is an absolute classic from beginning to end. Yeah, even though this film is a bit too short, even though this film was a bit shorter, 1 hour and 20 minutes long, so pretty much the same running time as Toy Story, but this is Aardman's very first movie, but it's such a really great film that if I ever see a DVD for it at HMV, which unfortunately have any copies left then, or CDX or Cherry Shops, I might consider getting this for the collection, because This is a film I do want to consider doing the opening logo and closing logo to the to this movie if I get the DVD for it. And I think I've done opening logo to this film on Netflix or Disney Plus. Kind of let me know if I did those two videos. I think I have done it because I've done a lot of opening logos a lot lately. So, and I will be doing some couple more during the week. So yeah. So overall, this movie, it gets a 10 out of 10. It's an amazing, brilliant masterpiece. So that's my review on Chicken Run. Stay tuned for my review on the sequel, Chicken Run, Dawn of the Nugget, which I know you guys might be thinking, Lamborghini Strikes Back, why are you 1 year late on this movie? I just never got around to review it, and at the time I haven't seen the first movie for so many years, but after rewatching the first film, I said, you know what, I think I should go review the sequel. So yeah, I'm actually going to review an actual good Netflix original movie. Because the last time I done a review or rant on the certain Netflix original film was Cuties. That film was awful. So yeah, so anyway guys, I'm going to hear guys. I'll stay to my review on Chicken Run, Dawn of the Nugget.